गुड मॉर्निंग सर, आई विल रीड द पॉइंट जस्ट यू नोट डाउन. द कंपनी इज एडवाइज टू ऑप्ट फॉर लीजिंग द एन इंडस्ट्री यूनिट डिजायर्स टू अक्वायर ए डीजल जनरेटिंग सेट कॉस्टिंग रुपीज 20 लाख विच हैज एन इकोनॉमिकल लाइफ ऑफ 10 ईयर्स एट द एंड ऑफ विच दैट असेट इज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैव एनी salvage value or residual value. The unit is considering the alternative choices of first one, taking the machinery on lease, second one, purchasing the asset outright by raising a loan. Lease payment 2,95,902 are to be made in advance. You have to keep this one word very important, are to be made in advance, and the lessor requires the asset to be completely amortized over its useful period. The cost of debt is worked out to be 16% per annum. The lender requires the loan to be repaid in 10 equal annual installment becoming due at the beginning of the first year. Average rate of income tax is 50%. It is expected that the operating cost would remain the same under either method. The firm follows the statutory method of depreciation and the same is accepted for tax purposes. As a financial consultant, indicate what your advice will be. This is a question. Okay? So based on this question, you have to answer it. Let's go with the solution of this problem. We have to find out the present value of cash flow. Present value of cash flow under lease alternative. Okay. So we have year end. Okay. Year. Then what is the next two heading? Lease, rental after tax. Then PVIF slash PVIF, then total present value. Okay, so here what we should write now? Yes. Focus all of you. I think I have not solved this kind of problem. Just focus here. So first we will take year 0. Year 0, how much you are paying? 2,95,902. Okay. So anything if I pay today, today is the amount of tax. Correct? Right? So tax will be the amount of 1 year, right? Yes or no? Tax will be the amount of 1 year. So today I am buying the machine, today if I am making payment, so there will not be tax advantage as of today. Now it will not have any tax advantage on the 0 year. On the 0 year, I will not have any tax advantage. So, no tax advantage, so I will write the same one. What is the 0 year, what is the present interest factor? What is the, this one, rate? 16% into 1 minus tax rate. Okay, so it comes to 8%. You check it out, 8% 0 year. All of you check it out, 8% 0 year. How much comes? 8% 0 year. Yes? 8% 0 year. Yes, 100% right. Whenever we calculate for 0 year, it's 1 because very simple. Today I have invested some money. What is the present value of that money? Same amount. Or today I invested and today I am withdrawing. How much interest they pay banker? Same. They not pay any interest, but they pay the same principal amount. So for that reason, we have to multiply by 1. Total 2,95,902. 9 or 2. Next, what we'll do? We'll go with 1 to 9 years. We'll take 1 to 9 years. Yeah, I'm not really sorry. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, fine. Yes, then 1 to 9 years. How much you're paying for 1 to 9 years? 2,95,902 into 1 minus tax rate. And somebody may be having the question, why I'm not taking tax rate for the previous year and now why I'm taking here? The reason is 0 year itself not having tax. Because of the reason they're not taking the tax over there. How much comes to? How much?
1 lakh.
951. If it is beginning of the year, then we should do this. If it is end of the year, we would have taken directly 1 to 10 years. Correct? If it is end of the year, we would have taken directly 1 to 10 years. Because it's beginning, we take for 0 year, then 1 to 9 same year, then the last one will take the 10th year. Okay. Tenth year, how much? 10th year, they will not be paying anything but 0 years tax advantage will not be getting. Correct? 10th year, they are not paying. 0 year, they are paying. That advantage, 0 year, they are not getting tax, but 10th year, they have tax, but they are not paying anything. 10th year, I will cut the law, but they have the tax advantage will come. Beginning of 0 year, that means first year. So, beginning of 0 year is the date of when we talk about 0 year, they are not paying any tax. But 10th year we have tax advantage. The 0 year what the tax you save, you get a 10th year. That is, after tax, you get the here it is 1 lakh. 1,27,950. So just find out the 1 to 9 years. 9 years, 8%. 6.247. How much comes to?
9,24,250.
Okay. So now we are not paying anything, but we are getting tax advantage of 1,47,951. So when we are getting this tax advantage? In the 10th year. Correct? We are getting the tax advantage only in the 10th year. So what is the 10th year present value? Not 1 rupee we should see, not the annuity. Present value of 1 rupee. Okay? 0.? Are you don't see the annuity table, see 1 rupee table because we are doing only for the 10th year.
0.463.
What is the value here? Multiplied. So now total present value. How much? 1 lakh.
88,650.
Got it? All of it clear up to this point? See, first year 0. This is the peculiar thing I want to understand. Because we are making the payment in the 0 year. That means, as soon as we get the machinery, instead of paying at the end of the year, we are paying at the beginning of the year. Because we pay beginning of the year, so we don't have any tax advantage for us. We are not paying because tax we pay at the end of the year.
Sir, we need to pay 10 because it will be 9 years.
10th we have only tax advantage. We are not paying, but we are getting tax advantage. Zero is what the tax advantage begin with, so that's the gain for the 10th year. What it comes? So first year we not get the tax advantage. Because so we are going to pay tax end of the year. 10th year amount what you want to pay. Okay, end of the 9th year is the beginning of 10th year. 10th year, whatever the amount we pay for the tax advantage we have at the end of 10th year. Covid scale? Is that clear to all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Total
here, 1,88,653. 653? Okay, right, yes. 2, 1, 3. Yes, exactly 3. Okay? This month you can do it. Rest all of you understood? Why we have taken 0 year, then 1 to 9 and then 10th year? Is that clear? Okay. Yes, anybody has any issues? All of you clear? Those are online? Yeah. Yeah, I'll explain it once again. Just all of you listen, those are online and offline. The issue here is, we are making the payment, the lease payment what we are paying at the 0 year. That means as soon as we register the machine, okay, we are making a payment. How much? 2,90,902. For that we will not have any tax advantage. Because at the moment we get on 0 year, we are not going to run the show and we are not tax on it. Okay, so for that what we do? We pay the same amount and total amount only 2,95,902. Because as we know, why it is one also is very simple. Because present value of the same, it's a present value itself. Again, it's not converted to present value. That's the reason we are taking the 1. Okay, if you multiply, get the same as here. Thus, I think that is clear. So then 1 to 9 years, total 10 payments we are making. 1 to 9 years, same amount we are going to pay. So that is end of 0 year. So that is when you are making next payment, end of 0 year, that is beginning of the first year. Beginning of the first year, till the beginning of the till the end of the 9th year or 10th year beginning, we are going to pay every year 2,90,902. The same amount we are going to pay every year. Whenever we make the same amount every year, what we should do? We should consider. So when you pay from 0, so we should take 1 to 9 years. That is 1 to 9 years we are going to make the same payment 2,90,902. So for that reason, what we have taken? We have taken yes 2,90,902, and for that we get a tax advantage. What is the tax advantage? 50%, what is the amount we pay, it is tax deductible. So 1,47,950 will get it. And 10th year, we are not paying a single pie. We are not paying because we have completed all the installment. But machine will be there for 10 years. 10th year we are running the machine. Machine we have taken at the beginning of the year. Machine we have taken the 0 year. We are making payment to 0 year. But the machine will be completed. That is once today I received. So, first we ask what is your age. When you born, at that time you will not say my age is 1 year. Correct? Say for example, somebody is born on say 18th of December. 18th of December cannot be his age. Correct? Next 1 year, you have 1 year. So, the same thing here. 0 year, you don't have a tax. Here the tax advantage where we get, no? Here we get the tax advantage. Hope it's clear. 2,90,902, 50% tax advantage we are getting here instead of getting there. Hope it's clear to all of you. The reason everything why we are doing this one is because we are paying the 0 year. 0 year is that beginning of the receiving of the machinery. You can gather a bank loan to the loan down to extend Madhra. So they take some 50,000 rupees and they will give you remaining 10 lakhs. Let's assume 10 lakhs 50,000 are taking. 50,000 they will take out. That is interest or EMI they will take. First EMI they will take and rest they will give. In the same way calculating here. Is that clear to all of you? 0 year, same amount, 1 to 9. We get 50% at 10th year, though we are not paying, but still we get a tax advantage of 50%. So total comes to 12,88,653. Is that clear? Okay. So next what you should do? You should calculate the present value of cash flow under buying current value. Okay. So now, in that first, what is the first one we should calculate? So by magnitude, first we have calculated year, then loan installment, then what else? What is next one? Tax advantage. Tax advantage on interest as well as principal amount. Okay, sorry. Interest and depreciation. Okay. Then net cash flow. Present value interest factor. Total present value. Okay. So now for us, what we should calculate? So first interest and depreciation we have to calculate. So go for the working note where we want to calculate the interest and depreciation. Okay. Calculation of repayment schedule we do it. Okay. What we should do here? Year. Then loan installment amount, or since we are right, loan amount. Then loan at the beginning. Then payment, we have two payments over here. One is interest, then we have principal, loan at the end of the year. And last we can take here tax advantage on interest. Tax advantage on interest. Though this is not their schedule, but still I take. So it's easy for you to do it. Here we take 0 to 2. Okay. Loan amount. What is the loan amount? How to calculate the loan amount? Cost divided by present value interest factor and NPV. Now very interesting is how to calculate present value interest factor and NPV. Because it starts with 0 here. So it from 1 year, you will take it as case, so 10th year. Because it starts from 0 year, so interest in that is the present value. So if you know 0 year, what is the value of 0 year? What is the present value of 0 year? 1. We know that present value of 0 year is 1. That is of 0 year. Okay, next 1 to 9. Present value interest per parent is the ticket from 1 to 9. 2.5.
2.6. Is it right what I have written? Yeah, yeah. Let us not just wait. 2.6. It's not 2.6. 6.2%, right? Is it right now? Okay, now if you add both things, how much will get it? 6.24% plus 1. 7. That is the amount which we have to do it. Sorry? Yeah, 16%. Here, why you don't take cost, no, off tax cost. 16%, 9. How much?
4.83.
Then 4.83 is supposed to be. So then
5.67.
Yeah, if you add, you get 5.67, correct? How much do you get answer? Cost is how much? 20 lakhs. Cost of the machine is? Okay, so 20 lakhs divided by 5.607. How much? Okay. Sorry, I think line got interrupted. Those are online, can you listen to me? Can you hear me? Okay. Yeah. First, what you should do is, I think this table, you are clear. So, first, we have prepared a present value of cash flow under buying alternative. Under that, we have taken table, year, loan installment, tax advantage, interest, depreciation, net cash flow, present interest factor, and total present value. In that, we have to point out two things. One is interest and depreciation. So, to calculate interest, we have taken one more table, where year, loan amount, loan at the beginning of the year, repayment of interest and principal, loan at the end of the year, and tax advantage on interest. Okay. So these are the things are there. Now, for the first, what you should do? You should find out the loan amount. How to find loan amount? Cost divided by PVIFA. Cost divided by PVIFA. So your calculation of PVIFA is very important here. So cost, you know how much is the cost? Arrived at cost divided by PVIFA. So it's your loan amount. Loan amount is cost divided by PVIFA. Now, what is the cost? 20. PVIFA? 5.607. Now, how we got this 5.607? So, for 0 year, or this is 1. And 1 to 9 is 2.5. 0 is always 1. And 1 to 9 is 4.607 plus 1. Alright, here, for 0 year, it is how much 1 will get it, and for 1 to 9 will get 4.607. So you should read the 16% and the 9 year. So always when you calculating the discount rate for calculating the cost, always for tax advantage is different. You know what we are doing? We are calculating for the purpose of loan amount. If you calculate the loan amount, loan always includes principal and interest, correct? Loan amount always includes the principal and interest. So for that reason, we should not deduct the interest amount, okay, or tax amount. So 16% and 9 years if you take, you get 4.607 plus 1, you get a 5.607. 20 lakh divided by 5.607, how much you get?
3 lakh 56,000.
This is the amount. All of it clear? Calculate clear, all of you? Okay. Now it's up to you how you calculate. Fill the I will explain it to you, just figure it out. Okay.
Just do this. Fill it up quickly. How much you are going to pay? No amount in the zero. Here, while paying the interest also, whenever you take the loan, how they are saying that? Is loan amount, you have interest is 16% and how you are repaying that 16%? You have to pay loan amount at the beginning of the year, you mentioned, correct? Though it's not, you have to prepare from the beginning of the year. That is zero, you have to start paying the payment. Okay? So zero here, how much we are paying? First installment, what is the amount? 3,56,000. 697, correct? This is the amount you are going to pay. Okay? And loan at the beginning of the year is how much? 20 lakh. And interest, how much we have to pay? How much interest we have to pay? Zero. Why zero? Because today I am saying loan, today should there not be any interest, right? So there is no interest over here. And principal repayment is 3,56,697. And loan at the end of the year. So how much is? 20 lakh minus 3,56,697. How much? 16 lakh. Okay. So that part, the tax advantage part, we'll take it later. Okay. Now, second year, see our loan amount remains the same. I'll write all the year loan amount. Yes, let's split it up quickly. What is the interest on 16 lakh 43,303? You have to pay 16% interest.
2,52,928.
2,52,928. Principal repayment? 2,62,928. Principal repayment. You people should be like a mercury. Fast and quickly you should carry. Correct me. How much?
93,000.
And what is the year loan amount at the end of the year? 92,7. 59,69. 58 or 59? Is right?
69, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, next. Loan at the end of the year.
15,49,535.
15,49,535. That 1 rupee just we have to adjust either this side or that side. Every time we keep on saying.
If it is more than 5 or more than 5, come next number. If it is lesser than, keep it the same number.
Next.
1,08,772. Okay.
14,40,752.
Correct now?
14,40,752, correct?
Yes.
51 to 54 is jumping.
52 is correct?
7? You just hear it. 64 or 62, yes, you have to clarify. 64.
Okay, so don't depend on the 1 or 2 piece, okay? Can you please?
See, if you complete, then only I can go for lunch. Keep in your mind and go quickly.
Sorry?
2,30,522.
One start from 2, one start from 30. 1 lakh.
Correct. Done with this? Yeah, quickly tell B first. Yeah, what's the known at the end of the year?
Advantage on interest. Yeah, tell me, tax advantage interest, first one.
1 lakh. No, sir.
Tax advantage interest, tell me.
1,31,000.
0 year. Okay. Second year. Loan amount is how much? Loan is 7. So interest
Quickly calculate interest. 1,64,333. What is that interest? 2,50,928. 50% of that. Tax advantage. You should write here tax advantage. Directly I am taking. There is no confusion, no? Directly I am taking tax advantage over here. Hope it is clear. Yeah, tell me what is the tax advantage? 1,31,000. Okay. 44,643. Okay. Next, how to find the depreciation? What is the cost of the machine? Depreciation is cost minus scrap value divided by number of years. Cost is 20 lakhs minus 0 divided by number of years is 10. 2 lakh. What is the cost advantage on this? 50%. Okay. Tax advantage is 1 lakh. Is it clear? Tax advantage is 1 lakh. How we got 1 lakh? 2 lakh into 50%. We get 1 lakh. Okay. Here it is. 10th year it is 1 lakh. Okay. Depreciation will be there for 10 years, right?
Yes.
So here we have to take 10th year. Okay. Now we need to find net cash flow, present interest factor, and total present value.
Will you
complete
it?
Those are online also, just check it out. First, what you should do? Net cash flow, loan amount minus interest plus depreciation. Whatever is first one, for example, 356,697 minus 0 plus 0. We had 356,697 minus 0 plus 0. Okay? So, answer we get is the same. 356,697. Second year, 356,697 minus 1,31,466 plus 1 lakh. That is 2,31,466 minus this amount. How much? 356,697 minus 2,31,464.
1,95,000.
Will you be able to complete this chart? So, all of you clear here? This side. All of you clear? So,
1,95,000.
1,35,000.
95,000.
95,000.
1,25,233.
Okay, complete out like this.
1,32,735.
Last year it is minus 1 lakh. Minus 1 lakh. Okay. Now we have to find out present value. Here will come 1. In the same way calculate, you have to calculate the present interest factor. Complete all these things, then multiply. What is the rate of interest you are taking?
8%.
Yeah. This is distracting you? Distracting you?
Zero.
For complete this, what you should do next? You should take present interest factor, then multiply it, okay? Then get the final answer. So what is the rate of interest you are taking?
8%.
16% divided by 2, that is 8%. 8%, 0 year, 8%, 1 year, like this, you should complete all the things. So then multiply again total present value. Then add total. If total is more than the lease rental, so then so whichever is low, which answer we should go with that.
Yeah.
Okay. You know, so what is then present value standpoint? There is no difference between so present value and today's value. Okay. So present value means present value. Okay. Present value multiply 1. So let's complete it.